correction, and any other characteristics of the data service.
Now, you have all this equipment. Where do the signals come from to the satellites?
I was hoping you were going to ask that. Let me show you a tape that we shot earlier today. Here we are on the roof of the ITN building. What you can see are two main antennas, a smaller data transmit antenna, and a number of receiving dishes. The two larger antennas, 6.1 meters in diameter, are used for transmitting and receiving television pictures and audio. These fully steerable dishes are operated independently. Two channels can be simultaneously transmitted and received on each antenna, which gives us a total capability of uplinking and receiving 8 television channels at any one time. Because we are so high up, we have a wonderful line of sight, enabling us to transmit to satellites both over the Atlantic to the west and to more eastern satellites covering Russia and the Middle East. Before the signals get to the antenna, they must first run through this building. In here we house the final transmit equipment. You may well wonder why we put such sensitive equipment up here. The reason is that the closer we have this equipment to the antennas, the better the quality of signal. As you can see, we're very much in the centre of London, close to the BT Tower. This, of course, is invaluable to any broadcaster concerned with communication costs and getting signals to Maxat. Being a complete media centre and in this central location, we're also well placed for production companies, even if it's simply a matter of dropping a beta SP off.
Okay, you can see we've got quite extensive facilities, and the fact that we are within the ITN headquarters building, which is a well-known media landmark in the middle of the city here in London.